In this short video, I'm going to go back to the basics of the observability platform Hubble. And one of the main features of Hubble is its ability to build a service map automatically for you, you know, zero effort. And Hubble is built on top of Cilium. So once you deploy Cilium, start deploying applications, you will see automatically a service map built for you to represent network connectivity between all your different microservices. Now, the example I'm using here is the example we use for many of the service mesh demo and service mesh lab, where we deploy the book info application, which is typically used for, developed by the people behind Istio. And we can deploy a ingress resource or a gateway API resource, and we can then access this microservices-based application through the ingress controller. And what you can see here is a diagram that showcases all the different microservices, product page, the set of reviews pod, and Node.js ratings, Ruby application for the details. And all of this is a very basic book information database, right? So we can see some information about book Shakespeare's, and you can put different reviews. And that's just great to showcase some of the kind of microservices architecture. Now, obviously, building this diagram on whimsical is a manual process, but what would be great is when you deploy this application, automatically when you start using it, a similar diagram is generated, which is what you have with Hubble UI, right? You can see I'm accessing my application through ingress, and it hits a product page, and then product page, I can go through the details, or I can go through reviews. And even if I click on the reviews, you see product page, two reviews, two ratings, which is exactly what you see, product page, two reviews, two ratings, right? And there's no, again, no effort in building this. And it gives you layer three, layer four information about TCP or UDP flows. Has all the context around the type of applications, things like Kubernetes labels, namespaces, and you can have more information about the flows that are used to build this service map. Right? You can see the source service and the destination service, but if I want to, I can actually provide the pod, provide the IP address of the pod, the verdict whether network policies is approved or denied or just simply forwarded the traffic, and even the TCP flag for this kind of transaction. And that's it for the first demo.